Let's learn how I reframe and edit travel content fast from multiple Insta 360 camera like this one without using Adobe Premiere or DaVinci Resolve on a 4K timeline completely free. If you like to put together multiple 360 files in one single timeline, fast with music, transition, and 360 VFX on a large desktop display or better inside Apple Vision Pro Mega Display, this is the Insta 360 Editing Masterclass for you. We will focus on improving your image quality from this noisy X3 clip into this. So if you are wondering why my Insta 360 Reframe video look like shot on a 4K Sony, this is the masterclass will get you there. Insta 360 basically make a CapCut desktop app with pro feature all free for their camera. So it is no better time to switch from your phone workflow into a desktop or spatial workflow. The future of video editing is rapidly changing. Let's improve your content game now. Cut that expensive Adobe annual subscription by mastering the brand new Insta 360 Studio now. Besides the price, a bigger screen than your iPad or iPhone, and free pro feature, there is a practical reason for switching. Only professional filmmakers or top-notch creators can tell you. Image quality degradation from multi-pass rendering. We already know cell phone render look like shit, and no real content creator use their phones for editing. What I meant by image quality degradation from multi-pass rendering is that you need to render any Insta 360 INSV file into editing ready format for Premiere and DaVinci Resolve editing in the second stage. Here is a demo of the image quality degradation in that process. Yes, you can use lawless ProRes render, but the files are big and unnecessary time suck. All this hassle just made me not want to finish my videos on time. That is why I have a huge backlog of contents, especially for travel content creators, which is lots of you watching right now. So, in short, this studio update is a big deal. Now, let's learn about the new interface. Right after you open up the new Insta 360 Studio, you see project creation. Hit new project allow you to create a new timeline project. You can set the aspect ratio and proxy. Proxy is a very important for 360 editing. In fact, I mentioned it more than 5 years ago before there was Insta 360 the company. This just shows you how OG I am in the space of 360 editing and how my tutorial impact the growth of the entire industry. If you want to stay ahead, tell your immersive story, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell. This is a brand new interface. You have the media, music, graphics and text, and free transition right here. The timeline window is right here and the property window is right here. In the workflow perspective, I don't start on project window, I begin at media. Import your footage shot on the Insta 360 X3, 1S 1-inch, Ace Pro, and Sphere here. Think media page as your media tab in DaVinci Resolve, where you review all your footage as a story editor, and only import footage that you need to keep things super organized. You can even start to reframe, trim here, and everything you do will update onto your project page. Under media, temporary media is where all your selects in media page. Jump in that clip, you see all your reframe edits are still here. These clips in the timeline will also be added into the project media. I would suggest when you are in the project page, do not go back to media. You can edit all your properties right here. So you can modify your reframe, add new keyframe animation, AI deep track, change your stitching and stabilization setting, recalibrate your stitching, add image processing like the new Motion ND, and even edit your audio and add audio AI denoise all within project page. Now you see how powerful the new Insta 360 Studio is and how remarkably simple the interface is. Now, we even have a short key just like DaVinci Resolve to speed up your editing. Command plus B for split and Command plus K to drop keyframe for reframing. If you need a reminder of all the short key, it is this button right here. The new studio also has autosave. Please check your autosave time right here. So far, there's no crashes on my Mac, but if you're on a PC, drop me a comment to let me know if you are experiencing crashing. I am here to help. Instead of selling you some low quality editing or night course you probably do not need. Insta360 is so easy to use. All you really need is practice and follow this channel just like all other advanced 360 creators. Drop me a like, Kimchi, we appreciate it. General Media is like the master bin in DaVinci Resolve for assets you use on all projects like your social media handle, logos, and Kimchi selfie. Drop them right here. The whole point of editing on a desktop or on Apple Vision Pro right here is to see your beautiful footage. 720p proxy is ugly, especially if your client is next to you. So if you change your mind, you can always click the empty space of your timeline to bring up the project settings, click modify, and 9x16 for social media delivery. So one edit, you can deliver on both a YouTube 4K timeline in 16x9 and also 9x16 on TikTok. Simply click the export right here. When you are done, use H.265 and 25 megabit per second bitrate for the final delivery on Instagram, TikTok, or YouTube short. Don't use AI remove grain right here yet. Insta360 is not a great software for that. Keep watching. I will teach you a better workflow. Now we have the interface down, so let's get hands on and edit the travel video of Italy with me. The best way to learn is using real world example. So load in some Insta360 footage and follow along. First, drop in X3, Sphere, and 1RS 1-inch into media page. I usually shoot with all my Insta360 cameras with even Ace Pro. For you though, it can be just one camera with different takes. Highlight the clips you want to use. Here is a 17 minute long video which I will turn into an epic hyperlapse. But then, I capture myself doing a bullet time right here. Nani? Which is a very interesting shot in front of the giant virgin side. So, I create a new clip under clip management right here. We name the new clip as bullet time BTS, which I will cut with my X3 bullet time later for social media promotion. Now, in the new clip, we will just speed up the clip and rename it as Hyperlapse. Do the same with all your selects and create different clips variation. Now, in project page, under temporary media, drop in our first Hyperlapse. Make sure you select your Hyperlapse edit instead of the bullet time BTS right here. 32x speed up is still too slow here. I can easily change the speed to 64x. If you don't see this quick speed editing setting, click the lighting icon right here and make sure to select Show Speed Editors. In the new version 5, you can have custom speed and set frame interpretation to optical flow to make your Hyperlapse look more cinematic. Use it to your advantage. Right now, it is a good time to design music. Edit to the beat is the only single most important advice I can give to anyone new to video editing. This make your video satisfied in a subconscious level, so easier to go viral and get more views. Go to music tab and pick your music. Free music here does not necessarily mean free music on YouTube or Instagram. I would suggest upload the music to your channel and checking copyright issue first before deciding. Insta360 told me it will allow you to use your own music in the next update. So make sure you also follow me on Instagram so I can update you that news via my stories. Jumping the music here, you see there's a big beat drop right here. This is a good indicator to add transition and cut into the next 360 video. The next shot is filmed on the Insta360 Sphere. Trim it if you see the snapping because I have this turned on to remove all gaps automatically. Another time saver feature I love. Here, I want to create that popular dolly zoom effect. Basically, when the camera moves forward, you zoom out. If you create that optical parallax effect, it's very attention grabbing. You might already see it on ShotLab on the mobile app, but here is how to do it manually, which is always better because you can time it with the music and the job and the beat and make it look better. Again, if you want to go viral on social media, always add it to the beats. Add a keyframe at the beginning, set it to natural view with no fisheye distortion. Go to the point you want to stop, add another keyframe and set it to fisheye. Zoom out right here, move forward, zoom out. Just remember that principle. You can play with the fisheye distortion right here to lessen the robbing effect to taste. Speed up twice, look at that! So freaking cool! You do notice some image quality degradation and noise on the edges. Don't worry, we'll fix it in the last step. Now, let's learn how to add a transition. Go to Transition tab, filter out only the 360 transition. I only use 360 because it is unique to Insta 360 and make your content stand out in the sea of other videos. Very cool! You can adjust the transition time right here or simply just drag them. In the final section, I add another keyframe and pick Tiny Planet view right here. So it has a smooth Tiny Planet transition to the next clip. You can adjust the transition timing with the curve right here. This one is the Easy Ease, which is the most natural looking one you can use 90% of the time. The rest, it is just repeating what I just did on beat with the music. Here is a manual hyperlapse with me walking with a long pole. I keep it to have some cool spinning effects. The rest is the same, two Tiny Planet intercut and another walking hyperlapse. At the end, I want to add the title of the location, so I just pick a free title from the text panel right here and just put it on top of my video. Done! Here is the masterpiece, take me less than an hour to create. Okay, now for expert tips. How can I have such a high quality video render on YouTube 4K or on Instagram? In export, I choose Lawless Codec ProRes. Render to your social media spec though. Then I drop in the video in Topaz Video AI. I have a link in the description down below. I am not upscaling it. Instead, I use AI Enhance. The default setting is usually good. In export setting, pick H.265 or VP9 if you are uploading on YouTube. Set it to constant bitrate, which is the key to having really good compression on fast moving action video. This is the feature only Premiere or professional editing software has, so this is a very important extra step to make your Insta360 video from good to excellence. We cannot color grade in the Insta360 studio yet, which is a shame, but we can add my awesome travel LUT right here in the render to gel everything together to have a consistent look. This will separate your video from amateur to professional without learning DaVinci Resolve, as long as you set camera setting to auto and have a great exposure and correct white balance. My travel LUT will work wonder. Even better, I offer this LUT to download completely free, link in the description down below. I only make money from my client as a paid professional videographer, not from you, my viewers. Hey, don't forget to drop me and this video a like and tag me on social media if you use my LUT and technique to create better videos, so I can use my following to help you to grow. Is there any drawbacks on Insta360 Studio compared to other professional non-linear editor? Yes, this is very much like CapCut. There's only one timeline layer, so you cannot overlay clips on top of each other just yet. It also has no color feature, so you still need DaVinci Resolve if you like to play with the color instead of just using my free LUT. You are limited to the motion graphic that Insta360 provides. Free is great and I am not complaining, but it is just not enough for pro editor. There is no animation graph, speed keyframe control, or audio editing feature. And that is why in the next tutorial, I will teach you Insta360 Adobe Premiere Reframe workflow. Well, everybody copy my first original GoPro FX Reframe tutorial, but this one right here is new, faster, and I guarantee you, you have not seen anywhere out yet. So head over there and I will continue to teach you more awesome editing knowledge.